Okay, folks, we're back. Part two, we're going to talk about some interesting stuff about our Freightliner cab. And not only interesting stuff I've been thinking about doing, I finally tried it on the Freightliner dump truck cab. We're going to be using the stock Freightliner AMT cab for comparison. Only differences on our front one, I already went ahead and did the seam rivet whole thing there, but other than that, the rest of the cab is identical, straight out of the box, the way AMT provided. We're gonna set up the tripod here to drop straight down. So, just real quick, what I want to cover, on our day cab here, I still don't like the wheel opening. But now we're talking about the back portion, the rear portion of it there. So I'm gonna go ahead and take pictures and graph them out and stuff, and enclose that correctly so it matches the real Freightliner prototype. The weenie way that AMT did this, it's something else. So let's just leave it at that. So this is what I've always noticed that the armor guys, what they do. Shoot, let me set this up on tripod. Hold on 1 second. Bring that tripod right here. Okay, our beloved armor guys, what I noticed they always do is they will, especially where this is a bad example, but especially where on older Tamiya kits on this walkway portion, because it's too thick. It was a Tamiya kit that was probably manufactured in the 70s, so this is a lot thicker than how the kits come out today, especially with the new styrene injection molded and a photo etch. So if you have an older kit, what these guys do is they'll sand or shave off material from underneath this, at least on the front portions where you can see that are visible, not the entire thing. So it gives you that look that it's a lot thinner, matching the prototype. And that's what I wanted to do here with our Freightliner models. You got these real thick pieces of styrene wall. So I said, what if I go in there and I start shaving that off like the armor guys do? And the results were spectacular. We'll do a comparison right now, but let's zoom in. I have no idea how to film this, so forgive me, guys. We went ahead and shaved. You want to do this before you assemble the cab. In my case, it was too late, so there's some angles you just can't get at. But I did do the windows, that center sill. As much around the wheel wells as possible. Including the front portion of the cab. Behind our center sill. Behind the window, this pillar here. The angle was horrible. It was too late, so I couldn't take out as much here. But I wanted to bring the window, the clear plastic window portion assembly that Freightliner gives you. I'm sorry, AMT gives you in the kit. I wanted to bring that forward closer to the outside edge of the cab as possible, doing that technique. And it did move it forward a little bit, and it improved the appearance that much more. So this is something I've always wanted to do. I had a good excuse to go ahead and do some shaving, and it's exactly what I did. This is the stock AMT. This is the improved version, my version of what I'm talking about. I'll just run the camera by different portions of it at close-up zoom, and you guys just draw your own conclusion. That one right there is pretty telling. Right here you can see the huge difference in material versus what I shaved off. You can barely see the edge there, just like real sheet metal. Let's get down here. Right here we'll start off again. Let's zoom in, fix the focus there. And right there, that part is kind of telling. Especially that's the front of the cab that's kind of noticeable. I don't know if we can tell from this shot here, but there's the shaved down center pillar versus the AMT one. So once again, this is your stock AMT out of the box with the thickness that it comes with. It's a good eighth of an inch easily, if not a little bit more, all the way around versus the more prototypical sheet metal. And keep in mind, we're only doing the outside visible edge. The rest of the model is still the same thickness as AMT designed it for sturdiness, even for my case. But it did lead to another fantastic idea, which I'll share with you guys here in a few minutes once we're done with this, which we're pretty much almost done. Now, that's just something I've always wanted to try on an AMT kit, just never got around to doing it. I had a good excuse to do it this time, and I wanted to share and film with you guys my results. Here, if you can see, try and get you a good angle here. The thickness, I sanded down the thickness of the window material here on the bottom, as opposed to the stock AMT, which is a lot thicker. Also did it, it's hard to see on this, I also did it to the top of the windows. It was a lot harder to do the top of the windows because I've already assembled the cab. So if you want to attempt something like this and improve the inside of your windows, you definitely want to do this before you assemble the cab. And one last thing I wanted to show with you guys. We'll install the window material onto our stock AMT cab. May not fit. not going to fit because of some bracing I have in there, but it's close enough. You know, we get that big step from the wall of the sheet metal outside of the cab before you get to the window, where in reality it's flush. It's part of the limitations of model making, unless you're really, really good and can cut out your individual windows, which does require a lot of talent and an extremely steady hand, which I do not have either. Now, when I install the window material onto our modified AMT cab, look at the magic that happens here. That step has been cut down pretty much about half. It's not as serious. And I was able to bring the front glass forward more than it comes straight out of the box. I was also able to do a little bit the side cab windows where we shaved the inside of the sheet metal. So my opinion, it improved the overall look of the cab. It made it look more delicate. If any of you have ever thought about doing something like this, or wondered about doing something like this, I'm going to go ahead and tell you, definitely give it a go. It does improve the overall look to the model, absolutely. If you don't see it, it's probably because you're not exposed to a Freightliner cab or cabs every day. 2, 3 years, 4 years now I've been doing this. So the image of Freightliner, AMT Freightliner cabs are burned into my brain, and immediately I can see the night and day difference, where someone who's just looking at this for the first time may not be able to see that. Another thing I did do that improved the overall look of the AMT cab, and you can see a little bit of it right there, is our AMT cabs, straight out of the box, come with these little, these high cheekbones on each end, where in reality it's more flat on the prototypes. So what I was able to do, and you can see how I did it right there, is I sanded down, and I didn't do it completely. I got to go back and finish that. I did one side only, so you can compare it to the other side where you can see the high cheekbone still. And that high cheekbone is not on the real Freightliners. It's only on the model AMT kits. So by sanding that smooth, I changed the overall look of my AMT cab. And when I had the lights set up to cast shadows, in other words, not... Well, I can't do it now. I'm not set up, but I'm not really set up. I got to, anyways, maybe I'll do that next video. It becomes more apparent. So maybe right there. But definitely you see that bump, that high cheekbone on this side, and it's pretty much gone on this side. Still got to go back and finish that a little bit more. That's also something I highly suggest if you want to improve the look of your AMT cab. So shave down the insides, shave off those high cheekbones, plus a bunch of other stuff I've been covering. And last but not least, this little experiment we did, led to something else that has me just as I'm as tickled as pie. As I was goofing around with this guy here, I was taking measurements. I was going to make a metal template for the windows, so using the same lacquer thinner metal. So I was doing measurements and stuff, and seeing if in terms of flatness, trying to figure out, is that high cheekbone on the real one and stuff. So I was doing a lot of templates and experimenting with light and shadows and stuff. And I started doing stuff like this.
And am I covering that correctly? I sure am. Just do like this. And I came across a conclusion, if you guys are seeing what I'm seeing, is that is, you know what? I'm starting to fall in love with these things so bad. And I'm going to do this. I'm actually going to probably start maybe this weekend. I don't know. I'm going to make a 125th scale AM 125th scale Freightliner cab over cab out of 100% sheet metal. And if it comes out the way I'm picturing it's going to come out, I might use that on all my Freightliner builds from now on. So I'm going to share that with you as I move that along. If I see it's growing legs, it's going to go somewhere. Maybe I'll dictate a build series video on that. If I just see it's kind of not, or maybe it's not all there, then I'll just introduce bits and pieces in my videos. And just for shits and giggles. So pretty much that is all I wanted to cover with all you fine gentlemen. Tell me this doesn't feel good.
It's a little too tall, could've used a few pounds. Tight pants, points, hauling her down. She was a black haired beauty with big dark eyes.
We had a great summer. We're having a great fall, we're gonna move into a great winter. You guys are building some amazing videos. I saw BNR's, Day Parsley's videos today. I'm glad you guys are joining me on this journey, and the advice, the love, the tips is what drives not only me, probably all of us. So, tell you what, man, these AMT kids, we say it all the time. Get a coupon, go down to Hobby Lobby. For $24, you get yourself an awesome kit. Give them some love, tear into them. Let's get some advice and some tips from other fellows on here on YouTube. And before you know it, she ain't going to look like an AMT kit. You're going to be down the road to some spectacular model building. All for $24 at Hobby Lobby or online or anywhere else. Or go down to your local hobby store and support them and pay full pop for it. You're not going to lose either way. It's a win-win deal for everybody all around. You know, times are tough right now all around the world. Inflation, gas prices, food shortages, supply chain shortages, diesel shortages. You got that motherfucker out there in Russia just decimating Ukraine and its people for no reason other than riches. Just make all that crap disappear. We've all been there. I say the story a million times. You're with your honey going down the aisle at Hobby Lobby. You keep sneaking back to the model aisle. Where they have all the kits. She thinks you're chasing some other girl. So she's suspicious. You think you're being cool, but she knows. Finally, here you come with a AMT kit in your arms.
I woke last night to the sound of thunder.
Right?
How far off I sat and
wondered. What did she say?
Started humming a song from 1960.
Honey, what is that?
It's funny how the night moves.
What's our answer?
You just don't seem to
have. Oh, baby.
Love as much to
oh, it's just for fun. I'm only going to build this, you know, just on a weekend, rainy weekend and stuff. What did she say? She just rolls her eyes. She goes, not another one. What a great hobby. Go ahead, buy that AMT kit. You got your heart set on. The one you remember from when you were a little kid. Your cool neighbor who had the actual big rig and he used to drive it for a living. We used to dream, remember? Having CB radios and watching Chips on TV and Channel 4 every Saturday night. BJ and the Bear. The movie Convoy. My brother actually has the 45 record from when that movie came out. Guys, we're only going to live once. Right now is our time. Right now, as I stand here before you, this is our time. This is your time. What the hell are you guys going to do with it, man? The whole world's going crazy with woke movements and pink hair and fucking Putin invading Ukraine. What the hell's his problem? There's a special place in hell for people like him. Right now is your time. You're alive here once, here and now. Won't you join us? Join us on this awesome trip. Scale model building.